Welcome back, everyone, to One Test Wonders, where we look at players that have only played one test match. This week, we go to Ireland, where we look at the One Test Wonder of Ed Joyce, the joyful One Test Wonder. Cricket will often see many great test series every year, especially with the recent introduction of the World Test Championship. This means that high-quality players get a lot of opportunity to play test matches, and this leads to it being rare for any player of a high quality to only play one test match. However, unfortunately, that is the case for Ed Joyce. Ed Joyce began his domestic career in 1999 with Middlesex as a top order batsman. It is here where I would like to have a look at his first recorded match on Cricket Archive, and following that, we will look at his first-class match in the domestic scene. Ed Joyce's first recorded match on Cricket Archive was for Leinster Cricket Union under 19 as a 16-year-old against Glamorgan Young Cricketers. In the first innings, he took two catches, but when he got to actually bat, he made a very nice 61. But it wasn't enough, as Glamorgan won by 15 runs. Joyce's first county match was for Middlesex against Worcestershire in 99. In the first innings, he took a catch, but didn't really perform with the bat, as he only made 9 runs. But this was not to show how dominant he would be as a player for years to come. Unfortunately, in the second innings, he was not required to bat, as the game petered out to a draw. Joyce impressed almost immediately, winning the Dennis Compton Award in 2000, given to the most promising young player across county cricket. Joyce continued to impress in the early 2000s, where he continued to average around 50. Joyce took over Middlesex as captain in the 2004 season. Joyce was born in Dublin, so he was eligible to represent Ireland. He was a star for the Irish team in the ICC trophy matches from the year 2001 to 2005, where he averaged a really good 84 across 14 matches. By the year 2005, Joyce had hoped to play international cricket at a higher level, as Ireland was still very young in international cricket. Joyce had an excellent domestic record, so when he completed his English residency qualification, he was selected for the English side, ironically making his English debut against Ireland and facing off against his younger brother, Dominick Joyce. Joyce played well in the ODI team and seemed to have cemented his place in the English team after a good performance down under, including a century against Australia at the SCG. Joyce was the third top scorer for England in the series, but Joyce had a disappointing 2007 World Cup, as England went out before the knockout rounds. So you could say they were knocked out before the knockout. This led to Joyce being dropped from the English side, where he decided to return to the Irish team for the 2011 World Cup. Joyce had made a big swap in 2008, where he moved to Sussex before becoming captain in 2012. His 2014 season was the best of his domestic career, where he averaged 66 and scored 7 centuries for Sussex. He returned to the English radar for the test team, but he was ineligible to play due to being part of the Irish team again. Joyce moved to the English international team to play test cricket, something that he was close to but never quite achieved. He was always going to struggle to play test cricket for Ireland, as they did not have test status for most of Joyce's career. However, Cricket Ireland always made it clear that they wanted to play test cricket, partly due to stem the amount of Irish cricketer playing for England, and partly because it was a long-term goal of theirs. Joyce was finally able to play the test match that he wanted to play in 2018 after Ireland were awarded Test status in 2017. Joyce was named as part of the team that would play Pakistan in Ireland for their first ever Test match. Joyce struggled in his first Test match inning, falling for just 4 to the bowling of Mohammed Abbas. Joyce's second inning was a lot better, where he scored a nice 43. It was not enough to ensure victory for the Irish, as Pakistan won the match by 5 wickets. Considering Joyce was 39 at the time of his first Test match, he decided to retire a week later from all professional cricket. It meant that Joyce had changed country twice in search for Test match cricket, but in the end, Joyce ended up playing for his home country. Joyce ended up playing only one Test match in his career, which also happened to be Ireland's first, so he joined the ranks of people that to play only one Test match, but also be one of the first 11 to represent their nation. He finished with an average of 23.5 across his one match. Joyce had a nice end to his career, finally getting that Test match that he wanted at the age of 39. And he is surely going to be recognised by Ireland for a very long time as one of their greatest. And even though he only played one Test match, he is still one of the great One Test wonders. Just as a postscript, when I was doing some research, I found that Steve Waugh of Australia ended up playing one game for Ireland in a first-class fixture against Australia A. It was clearly just a warm-up game, but it still counts as a first-class fixture, so you can almost say Steve Waugh represented Ireland. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the video and want to see more exciting cricket content, please hit the subscribe button and like the video. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time.